this is for people that want to make cartoon tracks. If you go on SketchFab, you look up cartoon tree, for example, you'll see some that are free, some that you have to pay for, but you can find some pretty good free stuff in here. Now, I usually don't try to download the stuff that are free. I'd rather use Meshroom to just look at the preview. Like, you can look at their preview and tell it to be, well, some of them say HD quality, some don't. But I prefer to just basically go around the model and just capture screenshots, and then I like compile them in Meshroom. That way it's basically baking all this into a material, and I don't have to worry about converting everything to, you know, BeamNG textures. You know, basically they're all can, like, maybe they're, I don't know how to say, maybe they are like procedural textures that render only correctly in Blender, but if you're trying to import this into the game, then you got more work to do. So that's why I prefer to just use Meshroom and get a bunch of screenshots and just let Meshroom make the mesh. And then of course I simplify the mesh and use that. But now, I would not say ever do that with something that you have to pay for. That would be stealing. Only like free things that are free, of course. So SketchFab does a very good job of showing you high definition models that you can look at full screen, which is like how real life works when you have Meshroom and you walk around an object taking pictures and you feed them into Meshroom. I mean, it's a time consuming process, I mean, but you know, it's just one way you can get things. But some people may prefer downloading directly. Like, this is an OBJ, for example, of a cartoon Stump. Credit the creator. See, now this is something else I don't like to get into. I mean, I don't mind giving people credit, but I don't really know how to give credit. I mean, I don't know, other than I got it off SketchFab. You know, what else do you really say? Give a link to it. Like, say, well, this is the model, this is the link that it came from, this is the person. I don't know, maybe y'all can tell me. But I typically don't use these models very often, mostly for that reason. But anyway, we got this tree. Let's load it into Blender. This was the lava I was making in the other video, the new general. All right, well, we'll get rid of all this stuff. We don't need this. All right, import in OBJ. It's probably zipped. I don't know why I would have thought it would not be zipped. What in the hell is that? That's crazy. Unzip. Stump tree. So what we get here? We get textures. Well, I guess albedo is basically a color map. I don't know why. It's like albino is what it looks like. Albino, whatever. Oh, this is the game. Hold on a minute. Let me get back into Blender. File import in OBJ Kenobi. OBJ. Yes, OBJ. Object. So we go to the source folder, import the OBJ, and we go to texture, and we see no texture. See, it's another thing that you have to do with these damn things from SketchFab. So no texture, default OBJ, nothing here, so we need to make a texture called cartoon tree. You can call it pink pickle. It doesn't matter what you call it. I'll just call it cartoon tree. And the best color, I'll pick image texture. And I will go to the downloads folder to stylize tree textures and pick that material. Now, I will not do the other materials because it's not going to make a difference, because the game will not be making any main dot materials based on any of these others or anything, so it's really pointless to hook them all up. Now, you'll want to check your poly count. You can go to decimate and see it's 1,000 polys. You can lower it if you need to get it more, you know, suitable to the performance that your system can handle. But I'm going to leave it like it is. I'm going to rename this long name to Cartoon Stump. No. Let me change the texture to Stump too. Here, I've been, I got myself confused. See? Now, you see the origin is this little dot. This basically is where the thing will rotate on its axis. If you're in the game, you're basically rotating this thing around. If you want it to rotate on its axis like this, that's fine. If you would rather it rotate to the default, I would say that's the default, but that's mostly what I assign origins to. That'll make it so that it rotates on that, which that's basically 000. Not to get sidetracked, let's not worry about this rotating and everything. You can rotate in the game too. Alright, now if you're going to just use this, it also is the collision mesh. I wouldn't even worry about doing anything in here. You can assign a collision mesh in the game, but it will be the same poly count as this, which is 1,000 polys. You really don't need 1,000 polys for something like this. You could just make a simple box to be your collision mesh like this. Let me reset this back. I done got it crooked now. Alright, see, you could make a add mesh. Well, let's make a mesh cylinder. And it don't need to be that many faces. We can be like this and scale it like this. You can make that a collision mesh and just rename it to COLMESH-1. And then the only thing is now you have to do the file structure, which, you know, if you got these closed, this is how this looks now. Just add two empty plane axes. Add two of them. And rename one to base 00 and the other to start 01. Hold shift, left click, drag and drop. Start in the base, just like that. And then do that with these two. You can hold shift to multiple select, and then hold shift again, left click, drag and drop, put them in the start. Now this has a proper collision mesh, even though it's not, you know. I mean, I guess I could go into edit mode, make it a little better. I reckon we could make it a little better than what it is. So that it, you know what, I'll show you something even better. In object mode, now I did add a loop cut, which that basically, it gives it more flexibility, basically. That's what loop cuts do. You'll see what I'm about to say here. We go to object mode, and we'll add a modifier to this. We will say shrink wrap. And we will pick the stump, and that's a better approximation for a collision mesh for that object. But you see these cuts wouldn't be here if I didn't add those loop cuts. It would still be a basic non-bendable thing. It wouldn't conform to this without those loop cuts, is what I'm saying. You could also do subdivisions in edit mode. You could just add subdivisions to the entire mesh like this. And, you know, it would conform even better. You don't have to add the loop cuts. You can just subdivide it a couple times. Also tell this to nearest vertex instead of nearest surface point, but that's up to you. You can also offset it a bit if you want it to be larger or slightly smaller than the mesh. But we'll apply the shrink wrap. Now we have a better collision mesh. We'll export the DAE collider into the level we want our tree in. Now this is going in small grid because small grid loads quick. Let's see here. Level, small grid, art. Now I'm going to make a new folder. Well, you know what? Hell, I'll just put it in here by itself like this. I won't worry about making a new folder. I'll just send it in there like that. Do it the old way. And it did copy the texture into there because I saw a little checkbox that said copy material. Now we load the level. Get out of here and reload small grid. Now before you import in that tree, you need to make this material. Or you'll have a red tree. They have no material on it. So F11, go into your material editor and say new material. New material. What name are you putting here? Well, that would be this name right here. Yeah, cartoon stump. Now this is the way I used to do textures, but it'll tell you if there's already one with that name. It'll have a little yellow warning down here. It won't let you create it. So we created it. Now we go to color map. Now we'll go to the in the art folder here and where is it at? I don't see it. I got to reload the game. Apparently. See it? I sure don't see it. There it is. Stump. Is that what I called it? Damn, man, I'm getting old. I'm forgetting every damn thing. Yeah, I guess I did. Okay, alright, so I was in the right place. See, it's white because I didn't add a color map yet. But it's not red. So now I can add a color map. It didn't put that texture in there, apparently. Oh well. Let's find out what happened. Oh, it is in there. Did I not see that? Am I blind? I don't see that shit in there. I just see asphalt. I thought JPEGs had to be JPG, not JPEG. That's probably what it is. See, I don't know what the deal is with that. I didn't make the damn texture, but. As far as I know, that's what a JPEG is. You got JPG, not JPEG. So we'll refresh. Regenerate directory. There it is. Drag it and drop it into the color map there. Now the other materials didn't go over there. They're still in the downloads folder. Alrighty, so that would be the normals, and I guess you could probably only really need the normals. Copy. Let's go back to the levels. Small grid, art. I'll just stick it in there. Alright, back to here. I'll just refresh the asset data again. Refresh directory. here's the normals map. Drag it. Now that showed up. I don't know, folks. I don't know. I didn't make the game. I'll stick that one in the specular. Ooh, that don't look good in there. We'll just use the albedo for the specular. Shouldn't make much difference. There we go. Alright, we'll save. And we got our cartoon stump. Compliments of who was it that we got this from? From this person here. Aartee is who contributed this 3D stump that is beautiful. And to rebuild collisions, we just rebuild collisions, and now we can drive into stump with car. Just like a soul. Just like soul. And there we go. We got a cartoon stump. So there's a lot of things you can download from that website. I mean, there's a lot of stuff. Some free, some not free. I mean, possibilities are endless. It's just how much time do you want to spend on it. I mean, you could probably find some good free ones in here. There's a lot of stuff in here. So I think this might help some people. Maybe, maybe not. Alternatively, though, if you prefer to make assets the way I do, where you are not having to go into here and make them, you have to make them alternatively by having your own main.material.json file instead of letting this generate it. Because what this will do, it'll generate it, but it's going to make it dependent on this location, which means it'll only work in this level. So if you go into the main.materials that was created for this, you'll see what I'm talking about. Cartoon stump. See, it's pretty much limiting this to this level only, but if you remove this and all you leave in there is default material, just basically take out the directory information like this. As long as the texture, the materials, I mean, you know, the images rather, as long as they're in the same directory with the model and the main.materials, you can move it into any folder. They don't have to have a location. So we'll resave this and we'll just make a new folder real quick here just to show you how this works. Dump. And so we'll put the DAE into that folder. Move here. The main.materials into there. Move here. And then the materials themselves move here. And now I'll just copy this and I'll go to another level, like say Derby Art. Paste it so that it has its own folder. See, it's got its materials in there, it's got the DAE, and it's got its own main.material. So now you can load that level, and that asset will be there, and you don't have to worry about going up to create a new texture. I'm like, well, how do you do that in the first place? Well, I leave a main.materials on my desktop at all times, that I just fill it out as I go. I'll just put in like a color map. You know, if I have other maps to put in, I'll let the game put them in, and then I'll just remove the directories after the fact. Because I can't remember all the stuff that goes into making one of those. There's a lot of stuff to remember. I can't remember where I set something down 5 minutes ago. I can't remember all the things going that. I won't pretend to know it all by reading off another screen and typing it. I just tell you, I don't damn know. I'd be lying if I did. I set the browser and let's find our stump. See, there it is in its own little folder, and there it is. Texture ready to go. Just don't forget to rebuild those collisions. Hope this helps some people. I would like to make a cartoon track at some point. I'd like to do a lot of things. I just don't know when I'll ever get around to it. So in the meantime, at least this gets some people into making assets that are cartoony in nature. Hope this helps. Let me know any problems.